the second question, which was really important, was can God become a man? And as I said, if Muslims even ask this question, they need to be shamed by that.
Why is
shame on them? Because they're assuming that God can't do something you and I can't be. Mm. God can't even do what we are.
أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أولئك يعرضون على ربهم ويقول الأشهاد هؤلاء الذين كذبوا على ربهم ألا لعنة الله على الظالمين الذين يصدون عن سبيل الله ويبغونها عوجا وهم بالآخرة هم كافرون أولئك لم يكونوا معجزين في الأرض وما كان لهم من دون الله من أولياء يضاعف لهم العذاب ما كانوا يستطيعون السمع وما كانوا يبصرون.
Question God and stop Muslims telling God what he can and cannot do. Muslims come up to me and say, you mean God went to the toilet? And I sit there and I look and I say, what? Of course he can go to the toilet. Can't your God go to the toilet? If he can't go to the toilet, your God's too small. Get a bigger God. Come on home. We've got him.
أولئك الذين خسروا أنفسهم وضل عنهم ما كانوا يفترون لا جرم أنهم في الآخرة هم الأخسرون إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وأخبتوا إلى ربهم أولئك أصحاب الجنة هم فيها خالدون.
The divine son, the eternal word of God, became flesh and dwelt among us, that he entered into his creation as Jesus of Nazareth, and that once he had taken on human flesh, his physical nature, since it was created and perishable, was capable of dying, even though his divine nature could not die.
وَقُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي لَمْ يَتَّخِذْ وَلَدًا وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ شَرِيكٌ فِي الْمُلْكِ ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا.
But if we have to agree on this point, why are Muslims so confused by the Christian claim that Jesus is God and that Jesus died on the cross? The real confusion on this issue comes from Islamic theology. You see, in Islam, it makes no sense for Allah to enter his creation to die for sins because Allah's justice, love, and mercy are all limited and imperfect.
يا عبادي إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار وأنا أغفر الذنوب ولا أبالي فاستغفروني أغفر لكم وعزتي وجلالي إن أتاني عبدي ليلاً قبلته وإن أتاني نهاراً قبلته وإن تقرب مني شبراً تقربت منه ذراعاً وإن تقرب مني ذراعاً تقربت منه باعاً وإن مشى إلي هرولت إليه إن استغفرني غفرت له إن استقالني أقلته إن تاب إلي تبت عليه من أقبل علي تلقيته من بعيد ومن أعرض عني ناديته من قريب ومن ترك لأجلي أعطيته فوق المزيد ومن تصرف بحولي وقوتي ألنت له الحديد ومن أراد مرادي أردت ما يريد أهل ذكري أهل مودتي أهل شكري أهل زيادتي أهل معصيتي لا أقنطهم من رحمتي إن تابوا فأنا حبيبهم وإن لم يتوبوا فأنا طبيبهم أبتليهم بالمصائب لأطهرهم من الذنوب والمعايب الحسنة عندي بعشرة أمثالها وأزيد والسيئة بمثلها وأعفو وأنا أرأف بعبدي من الأم بولدها. ما دام القلب ينبض، ما دام في بقية بالحياة، لنبادر إلى التوبة. والتوبة رحمة الله، وما أمرنا أن نستغفره إلا ليغفر لنا، وما أمرنا أن ندعوه إلا ليجيبنا. لو جئتني بملء الأرض والسماء خطايا غفرتها لك ولا غيرك.
And imperfect. For instance, what does the Quran say about Allah's love? Allah does not love those who exceed the limits. Allah does not love any ungrateful sinner. Allah does not love the unbelievers. Allah does not love the unjust. Allah does not love him who is proud, boastful. Allah does not love the extravagant. Allah does not love the treacherous. Allah does not love the mischief makers. Allah does not love any arrogant boaster.
A Psalm of David. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my sighing. Listen to my cry for help, my King and my God. For to you I pray. In the morning, O Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning I lay my requests before you and wait in expectation. You are not a God who takes pleasure in evil. With you the wicked cannot dwell. The arrogant cannot stand in your presence. You hate all who do wrong. You destroy those who tell lies. Bloodthirsty and deceitful men the Lord abhors. But I, by your great mercy, will come into your house. In reverence will I bow down toward your holy temple. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make straight your way before me. Not a word from their mouth can be trusted. Their heart is filled with destruction. Their throat is an open grave. With their tongue they speak deceit. Declare them guilty, O God. Let their intrigues be their downfall. Banish them for their many sins, for they have rebelled against you. But let all who take refuge in you be glad. Let them ever sing for joy. Spread your protection over them, that those who love your name may rejoice in you. For surely, O Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with your favor as with a shield.
First chapter of the Quran, the first in our series, The Straight Way, it's titled, and this is Surah 1, Surah Al-Fatiha in the Quran, verse 6. If you look at the Quran, the first chapter of the Quran, Surah 1, verse 6, it says, show us the straight way, Yusuf Ali, or guide us to the straight way or the straight path. In the Arabic, we find ahadna, ahadna, ahadina, al-sirat al-mustaqim. What's this ahedna or ahedina? I'm no perfect Arabic reader, but I know what it means. I know how to read it well enough. And the point is, ahedna or ahedina is show or guide or lead. And so five times a day, Muslims pray Surah Al-Fatiha. True Muslims are to pray towards the Kaaba, bowing down five times a day. And part of the prayer that is prescribed in the hadith is they are to pray this, show us the straight way, lead us to the straight path. But you know, it's very interesting because as Christians, we never have to pray, show us the straight way. You see, this is yet another bridge to the Messiah. Not that we find this as truth, but this should make Muslims doubt. Why do we have to pray five times a day, show us the straight way, guide us the straight way, lead us the straight way? Is not the Quran a straight way?
She gives birth to her God, who comes to save her and the rest of us. And that, I mean, think about that for a moment. Mary is now in heaven. Now, she doesn't have a physical body. She's a disembodied spirit because her body's, you know, went to the grave. And as she's seeing her son in his glorified physical body in heaven, she looks at him and she goes, oh, that's my son. But that's also my God. My God became my son, and my son is my God. And that's just too much. Too much stuff, right? No wonder I'm going bald, my brother.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله ولا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا لن يستنكف المسيح أن يكون عبدا لله ولا الملائكة المقربون ومن يستنكف عن عبادته ويستكبر فسيحشرهم إليه جميعا.